Hello, I'm Simon Whistler. You're watching Top 10sNet, and in the video today, we're looking at the top 10 reasons we're going to colonize Mars. We've got some awesome news for you. Right now, you are standing on the edge of history. Yes, you. Sometime soon, something's going to happen that will send you tumbling over a whole new era of human evolution. We're going to colonize Mars. You heard that right, the big, cold, lonely lump of rock spinning through the endless void 54.6 million kilometers away. We're gonna land there, and we're gonna build small bases, biodomes, research labs, houses, and eventually, well, cities. We can guess what you're thinking. Yeah, right. Sure, Mars seems like a long way away right now. Colonizing it sounds like the stuff of a science fiction film, perhaps one that stars Matt Damon freaking out about a bunch of space potatoes. But it's much, much closer than you might think. At some point in your lifetime, there's going to be a functioning civilization on the red planet. But how can we be so sure? Well, we're glad you asked. Number 10. Risk insurance. Imagine you're out and about, strolling the beach or whatnot, then you stumble across a nest of dinosaur eggs. Like, real-life dino eggs. The kind that haven't been seen for millions of years. As far as you know, they're the only ones in existence. They seem to be doing okay, but you can't help but wonder whether they're as safe as they seem. What if some predator comes along and eats them? What if some kid stomps on them? Isn't it kind of your responsibility to move those few eggs to make sure they survive? In a nutshell, that's the problem facing humanity today. Like the eggs, we're doing fine right now, safe and sound on the planet Earth. But like with the eggs, our safety could all be an illusion. There's a chance that a meteor could come along at any moment and wipe us out. It's a slim chance, sure, but it's not impossible. And here the worry starts to creep in. As far as we know, humans are the only intelligent life in the universe. Like the dino eggs, we could be invaluable. Isn't it our responsibility to spread out in case some meteor metaphorically stomps on us? And it's an argument that's proved pretty popular. This is why, by 2022, SpaceX is aiming to land on Mars. Number 9. It's a challenge. Make no mistake, getting to Mars is probably the biggest challenge humanity has ever faced. Most of us probably can't even grasp the technical leaps required to colonize a whole other celestial body. But you know what else seemed like an impossible challenge? Establishing a permanent base on Antarctica. Heck, even getting to Antarctica in the first place, or climbing Everest, or navigating the Northwest Passage, or colonizing the New World, or, well, you get the idea. If humans were a sensible species that erred on the side of caution, we'd probably still be living in caves, congratulating ourselves on not being dumb enough to venture out into the saber-toothed tiger-infested woods around us. But sensible is exactly what humans aren't. We do dumb things, like climbing a mountain we know could easily kill us, just to say that we reached the top. We even build civilizations in horrifically hostile places like Greenland and the Sahara, for Pete's sake. What we're trying to say is that humans rise to challenges, especially crazy ones like setting up a base on Mars, and especially when there's the added incentive of competition. And that leads us to number 8. Competition between nations and companies. Landing on the moon was arguably one of the biggest wastes of money in US history. The entire Apollo program cost the equivalent of $110 billion, that's in today's dollars, a sum that doesn't include the earlier Mercury and Gemini programs necessary to prepare NASA for Apollo. And what did Americans get out of it? Well, there are two answers to that question. The utilitarian one would go something like a dude standing on a lump of rock, but the other one would ring much truer. The US got something tangible from Neil Armstrong stepping onto the lunar surface, a sense of prestige, a sense of national pride. The last part is the key here. The only reason man never set foot on the moon was because the Americans were terrified Russia would get there first. During the space race, it was calculated that spending insane amounts of money was preferable to losing the propaganda war. Fast forward to 2017, and we might be witnessing the dawn of Space Race 2. Like all sequels, SR2 is going to be bigger, crazier, and chock-full of extra characters. China has already declared it wants to get to Mars in the next decade. NASA wants a man on Mars by 2030. India is sending satellites and probes. Then there are the private sector actors. SpaceX is already facing competition from Blue Origin and, to a lesser extent, Mars One. With everyone aiming for that sweet Martian prestige, expect to see Space Race 2 hotting up like crazy. Number 7. We already have the technology to get there safely. One of the big stumbling blocks for a Mars mission, let alone a colony, has long been getting there. Mars is 182 times further from Earth than the Moon. Getting there will require flying for over 6 months. There are also cosmic rays to deal with. Then there's the problem of landing on a planet with gravity and atmosphere conditions very different to Earth's. Many have called the idea impossible, at least without killing the astronauts. Yet, this all overlooks one key fact. We already have the technology to get there. For years now, SpaceX have been flying payloads for NASA to the ISS. As part of each mission, they've casually tested some of their Mars landing tech on the site. Importantly, they've been doing it at a distance of 40 kilometers to 70 kilometers above the Earth's surface, where our atmosphere perfectly mimics conditions on Mars. And they've succeeded. Repeatedly. The ingredients for a successful Mars landing are essentially already there. And what about those pesky cosmic rays? NASA already has the tech to eliminate around 33% of the risk they pose, and engineers are confident that the number is only going to increase. Number 6. We have the technology to make Mars habitable. Here's a quote to blow your mind. It comes from aerospace experts Christopher McKay and Robert Zubrin, and we're going to reproduce it exactly as they said it. In a paper, the two wrote, "A drastic modification of Martian conditions can be achieved using 21st century technology." We're emphasizing this quote because it's a really important one. What they're saying is that it's entirely possible for humanity to start terraforming Mars using technology we have at our disposal right now. That's right, man in 2017 is so advanced he can literally change the surface of an entire alien world, though for some reason he chooses to wear sweatpants in public. Weird, eh? If you don't read sci-fi, terraforming means changing a planet so it becomes more Earth-like and thus more livable for humans. On Mars, that means we could trigger a deliberate greenhouse gas effect that would melt the ice at the poles. This would release a load of CO2 and make the atmosphere denser and trap more heat and energy from the sun. Then we'd have liquid water and could start planting. Little mosses at first, but then plants, flowers, and even trees. The end result would be a planet that looked like Earth, was warm enough to not kill us, and had a bearable pressure. The air wouldn't be breathable, but even that could change. A few centuries after terraforming, Mars could have an atmosphere as breathable as that on Earth. Number 5. We already know there's water there. Water is the main ingredient we humans need to live. No water, and well, the deal is off. Luckily, Mars has something that very, very few other planets in our solar system do, and that's ice. And Mars has lots of it. It has frozen H2O just waiting to be thawed, filtered, and used to keep a human colony alive. And we're not exaggerating here. Beneath just one stretch of the Martian plains, NASA have discovered a single ice deposit containing as much water as the whole of Lake Superior. It exists in an area known as Utopia because it would be easy to land a craft there and then drill down to extract the water. And that's just on the plains. Go to the poles and you'd be sitting on enough water to keep a civilization running more or less eternally. If you melted all of the water on Mars, you'd end up with enough water to drown the planet in an ocean 30 feet deep. This means you wouldn't need to transport your own water from Earth, something so hideously impractical as to make it effectively impossible. It also means that you could sustain not just an expedition, but an entire colony. If we reach the point where there are a million people living on Mars, we'd be safe in the knowledge that their water supply would likely never run out. Number 4. Mars probably has the minerals we need too. Of course, building a habitable city on another planet takes a lot more than water. It requires an insane amount of construction materials, which would cost an eye-watering sum of money to send from Earth. At least it would if we didn't have an alternative. But we probably do. There's a relatively good chance that Mars has the minerals we need to start building our space utopia. We should stress the relatively part of that sentence, though. We don't have a huge amount of geological data on Mars, and NASA have been unable to identify any large ore deposits. However, they have identified areas where the probability of mineral deposits is quite high. Nickel, copper, platinum, titanium, iron, and silicon dioxide are all likely to exist on Mars, along with clay for making porcelain and pottery. Put it all together, and you have the fundamentals for building some pretty complex stuff. As for the technology to extract it, well, the basics are already there. We could use bacteria to mine from ore, or we could just develop robots to do some old-fashioned digging. Number 3. The idea has big backing. Every grand scheme needs its visionary backers. Without Columbus, you wouldn't have the New World. Without Genghis Khan, you don't have the Mongol Empire. Without JFK, you don't have Neil Armstrong standing on the moon. Luckily for humanity's interplanetary prospects, we already have our Mars visionary. In fact, we've got more than one. The most famous is the guy we've already mentioned a few times in this article, eccentric multi-billionaire and possible supervillain Elon Musk. He's been pushing private sector space exploration from a dystopian dream to a benign reality. Through his company SpaceX, he's made huge technological leaps towards making Mars colonization a thing we could actually do. But he's not the only one. Another founder, Jeff Bezos, is also determined to get millions of humans into space and living on other planets. Like Musk, he has the money and the technology via his private space company, Blue Origin, to potentially make it happen. And then there's the signals coming from the current administration. In March of 2017, Trump signed a bill making manned exploration of Mars an official part of NASA's mission statements. The last time humanity looked this serious about space exploration, it resulted in Neil Armstrong walking on the moon. Number 2. It will drive technological change on Earth. One objection that often gets raised when talking about Mars is that we should focus on solving problems here on Earth first. Well, what if we told you that the two aren't mutually exclusive? That by going to Mars, we will improve life for billions of people here on Earth? If you're intrigued, well, you should be. Technological advances in one area often bleed through into other areas, and this is often in hugely unpredictable ways. When Hubble was first launched, it had a fault in its lens that meant images came back all blurry. For 3 years, NASA scientists were stuck trying to decipher photos that looked like a dog's regurgitated dinner. So they developed an algorithm to detect images in all of the mess. It was a really good algorithm. It was so good, in fact, that it turned out to be excellent at detecting early-stage breast cancer from X-ray images. There are thousands of people alive today because NASA messed up with Hubble. Need some more examples? Well, okay. NASA has given us technology from portable vacuum cleaners to freeze-drying to modern firefighting gear, as well as grooved tires and roads that lower the number of car crashes. Artificial limbs have also drastically improved thanks to NASA tech, as have insulin pumps. And that's just from trundling around in our own planet's orbit. Imagine what totally unexpected stuff could result from the process of landing on and terraforming Mars. Number 1. Destiny. Stop and think about the future for a moment. No, we don't mean 5 years from now. We don't even mean 50 years from now. We mean hundreds, if not thousands, of years from right now. We mean a span of time as great as that separating you from Jesus or Julius Caesar. What do you see happening to our species when all of that time has passed? Where are we? One cynical answer might be dead, or wiped out by disease, or destroyed by artificial intelligence. But when you move away from the worst-case scenario, a clearer picture likely emerges of humanity spread out across the stars, of colonies on Titan and Ganymede, of cities in space, of exploration beyond the edges of the Oort cloud out into the depths of our galaxy. Imagine a future where we have the space and minerals for everyone. You could even call it our destiny. Now, terms like manifest destiny come with a lot of historical baggage. It was destiny that led European settlers to kill a whole lot of Native Americans. But Mars doesn't have any native population at all, unless they're really, really good at hiding. Nor does the rest of our solar system. Humanity can expand without prejudice or violence, or anything but a Star Trek-style desire to explore and learn. And when you put it like that, we come to maybe the simplest, best reason we have for colonizing Mars. Why on Earth would we choose not to? So I really hope you found that video interesting. If you did, please do hit that thumbs up button below. And don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already for brand new videos just like this every day of the week. Also, if you enjoyed this video, please do check out some of our other videos that are over there on the right. And thank you for watching.